Today I am going to discuss about the long transmission line, the performance of transmission line based upon the operating voltage, based on the line length it is classified for short transmission line, medium transmission line, another one is for the long transmission line. Already we know that in the long transmission line, the line length is that is greater than 240 km and the operating voltage is greater than 100 kV. That is practically it's considered for 132 kV transmission line, 220, 400, and then 765 kV transmission line. That is, the line length is greater than 240 km and the operating voltage is greater than 100 kV is considered for the long transmission line. In the long transmission line, the parameters are available for resistance, inductance, capacitance, another one is for the conductance, that is the leakage conductance. In short transmission line, due to the less line length, less operating voltage, that is less than 20 kV, less than 80 km, the parameters are only two parameters. One is for resistance, another one is for the inductance. But in the medium transmission line, three parameters are there. That is, the operating voltage is in between 20 to 100 kV, and the line length is 80 to 240 km. 80 to 240 km. The parameters are available for resistance, inductance, another one is for the capacitance. For balancing of the capacitance, again it is classified into end condenser method, nominal T, and then nominal pi method. In long transmission line, that is, the line length is greater than 240 km and the operating voltage is greater than 100 kV. That is, above 240 km, that is either 500 km or 700 km, all considered for the long transmission line. Practically, in transmission line, it's considered for the 132 kV, 220, 400, and then 765 kV. In India, AC transmission line, the maximum operating voltage is 765 kV. Here, in long transmission line, there are four parameters are there. One is for the resistance, inductance, capacitance, another one is for the conductance. That is, generally here, the four parameters are there. Vs is the sending end voltage, Vr is the receiving end voltage, Is is sending end current, Ir is receiving end current, and R is resistance per phase, XL is reactance per phase, B, that is capacitive susceptance, G, leakage conductance, Due to the long transmission line, the n number of parameters available. This is represented for R by N and then XL by N. We don't know the how much the length. For that purpose, we are taken for the here we are assuming a single phase long transmission line. It consists of two conductor. One is for the phase, another one is for the neutral. That is, we are considered single phase over a transmission line. It consists of two conductor. One is for the phase, another one is for the neutral. That is, the sending end voltage is represented for Vs and the sending end current is Is. Receiving end voltage is Vr and the receiving end current is Ir. And the four parameters are there, that is resistance is represented for the R, inductance L, the capacitance C, and the conductance is represented for the G. Conductance is represented for G. That is, R is resistance per phase, that is inductive reactance, that is XL. XL is represented for the inductive reactance per phase. And capacitive susceptance, that is represented for B, and leakage conductance is represented for G. Leakage conductance is represented for C. But R and L is connected in the series impedance. That is, the resistance and inductance is connected in the series element. Capacitive susceptance and then leakage conductance are connected in the shunt element. Capacitive reactance and then leakage conductance are connected in the shunt element, that is connected in the parallel. Now, like that, the n number of up to the is connected in the n number of, we don't know the how much kilometer, that is connected in up to the n length. Now you can go through it. And the R and L, that is, it is represented for the impedance that, is Z equal to R square plus XL square. And this is represented for the admittance Y, that is, capacitive susceptance and then leakage conductance. That is Y equal to B square plus G square. That is square root of B square plus G square. That is series impedance represent for the Z, that is series impedance is connected in the R and XL, that is Z equal to square root of R square plus XL square, and the shunt admittance Y, that is G square plus B square. In the long transmission line, it consists of four parameter: resistance, inductance, capacitance, another one is for the conductance, that is the resistance R, and the inductive reactance is XL. Capacitive susceptance, that is represent for the B. Leakage conductance is G. Here the leakage current is connected in the admittance, that is connected in the parallel. Generally the leakage current is higher in the sending end side and goes on decreases towards the receiving end side. The leakage current sending end side is the maximum and goes on decreases towards the receiving end side. That is, the sending end side, the leakage current is more due to the effect of the capacitance. The leakage current is affected due to the capacitance. But the R and L is connected in the series element, and B and G is connected in the shunt element. That is, the impedance is represent Z equal to R plus JXL, that is represent for square root of R square plus XL square, and the shunt admittance, that is represent for the Y, that is Y equal to square root of G square plus B square. The another name of the long transmission line is the rigorous method. Now this is the analysis of the long transmission line, that is represent for the rigorous method. For simplification, either short transmission line or medium or long transmission line, we want to derive the two parameter. One is for the sending end voltage, another one is for the sending end current, that is Vs and then Is, because the finally we want to show for ABCD constant parameter, that is AD minus BC equal to 1. Already we know that in ABCD constant parameter, that is the sending end voltage Vs equal to AVR plus B into IR, and the sending end current Is equal to CVR plus D into IR. For that is the long transmission line, the another name is represent for rigorous method. For simplifying the circuit, this is the, in this the circuit for simplification is complicated. For that purpose, that is Z and XL is represent for the impedance, that is simply represent for the Z, and the B and G, that is capacitance and conductance, is represent for the admittance Y. For simplification of the equivalent circuit, that is the sending end voltage is represent for the Vs, the receiving end voltage is Vr, and the impedance is represent for the Z, and admittance is represent for Y. Admittance is represent for Y. We don't know how much kilometer, but the long transmission line, that is the line length is, that is greater than 240 kilometer, greater than 240 kilometer. But in the particular transmission line, we don't know how much kilometer, that is either 300 kilometer or 500 kilometer, 700 kilometer. We are assuming in this the particular point, in this the particular point up to the receiving end point, the particular point up to the receiving end point, we are assuming the X meter, that is the X kilometer. We don't know how much the length, that is already we know that, that is 240 kilometer, greater than 240 kilometer is represent for the long transmission line, and the operating voltage is greater than 100 kV. But here in this the particular point P2 up to the receiving end voltage, we don't know how much the length. We are assuming X kilometer. Small change of distance, that is represent for the dx, the small change of distance is represent for the dx. In this the, here this is the sending end side, the receiving end side. In this the particular point to up to the receiving end point, the distance we are taken for the X kilometer, that is either 250 kilometer or 300 kilometer or 400 kilometers or etc. And the small change of distance at X is represent for the dl, that is the impedance is represent for Z into dl, and admittance the small change is different Y into dx. And here V plus dV, that is V plus dV is considered for the sending end side. Here some amount of drop is there in the line loss, that is I square R losses, that is the output the V in the sense the voltage at the receiving end side, V plus dV in the sense voltage at the sending end side, and I plus dI the current at the sending end side, some amount of the drop is there, and I in the sense that is the current at the receiving end side. Here the V R in the sense resistance per phase, XL means reactance per phase, that is the impedance represent for Z equal to R plus JXL or square root of R square plus XL square, and the V in the sense that is voltage at the end of the element toward receiving end say. VR is receiving end voltage, VS is sending end voltage, IS is sending end current, IR is receiving end current. And V, I plus DI, that is current entering into the element DX, that is including the losses. And I in the sense current leaving the element DX, that is I in the sense that is nothing but the receiving end current neglecting the losses. And we know that small change of element we are taking at a distance of X, the small change of distance is represent for the DX, that is the series impedance we are represent for the impedance is represent for Z, that is Z equal to square root of R square plus J X square, that is simply represent for the impedance Z, that is Z into the small change of distance DX. And admittance is represent for Y, that is small change of distance is Y into DX, but Y in the sense that is square root of G square plus B square, G square plus B square. Now in this the circuit, the simplified the long transmission line, the another name is nothing but the rigorous method. We want to find out the two parameter, one is for the sending end voltage, another one is for the sending end current. Now that is in the rise in voltage. The rise in voltage means the voltage in the transmission line is, it should be varying based upon the requirement. That is, we can boost the voltage from 11.3 or 6.6 11 kV to up to 765 kV, that is 66 132 220 400 and then 765. The voltage it should be boosted, but the current it should be differ, because the current is connected in the parallel, it should be divided. That is the raise in the voltage over the element at a direction of, that is increasing, the X equal to, what is the value, dV. The X equal to, this is nothing but the drop, X equal to dV. Already we know that according to Ohm's law, I equal to V by R. According to Ohm's law, I equal to V by R. What about the voltage by cross multiplication? That is V equal to I into R. V equal to I into R. But here we are considered for the impedance. That is, the voltage is a product of current into the line impedance. The current into impedance. Just you can, that is the voltage equal to current into impedance. The voltage in the sense that is represent for the change of voltage dV. The current is I into the impedance in the sense represent for Z at a distance of dx. At a distance of dx. Here we can write down the current I by cross multiplication. What happened? I equal to 1 by Z into dV by dx. That is dV by dx equal to, that is the change of voltage by cross multiplication. That is dV by dx equal to I into Z. You can, in this equation, we can write down the I, that is 1 by Z into dV by dx. Similarly, you can write down the current equation, that is the current equal to voltage into vice versa admittance, that is difference of the current entering the element and leaving the element. What is the change of current here entering the element? I plus DI. What is the difference at the end leaving the element only for the I? That is the change of the current is represent for the DI. That is the current is a product of voltage and then admittance. Admittance is represent for Y. That is current I equal to V into Y. Here the change of current, that is DI equal to voltage V. Admittance is represent for the Y and the small distance is represent for DX. Here write down, that is what is the value of V? V equal to 1 by Y into DI by DX by cross multiplication. That is DI by DX equal to V into Y. Or the simply you can write down V equal to 1 by I into, sorry, V equal to 1 by Y into DI by DX. Now differentiating this equation one, here the variable is nothing but the X. Differentiating equation one with respect to X, what happened? D square V by DX square equal to, this is Z is constant term, I is variable, that is Z into DI by DX. That is, we can differentiating equation one with respect to the X. That is, once we are differentiating with respect to X, what happened? D square V by DX square equal to, that is Z is constant, I is variable, DI by DX. The same inside, that is D square V by DX square minus, sorry, equal to Z into V by, that is DI by DX means, that is DI by DX. Here you can see that is nothing but V into Y. V into Y. And the substitute this value, that is d square V by dx square equal to Z into V by. This is the solution of the equation 3. It is in the form of, that is d square v by dx square minus v into zy equal to 0. This is in the form of y double dash minus y equal to 0. This is second order term, y double dash minus y equal to 0. Now y double dash minus y equal to 0, for simplifying the circuit in the second order, the first term is represent for the e power t, and the second term is represent for the e power minus t. The any constant term here we have taken, the first term the constant is represent for the c1, and the second term the constant is represent for the c2. Now what is the value of the y equal to, in the second order term, it is in the form of y double dash minus y. This is second order term, that is v double dash minus v, that is y equal to c1 into e power t plus ct into e power minus t, c2 into e power minus t. This is for simplifying of this equation 3, it is in the form of y double dash minus y equal to 0. That is, here we are taking, what is the term here? Square root of yz is nothing but the constant. It is in the form of d square v by dx square minus y into zy equal to 0. That is, the roots of the above equation is represent for plus or minus square root of yz. Plus or minus square root of yz. That is e power square root of yz. Now what happened? The simplifying, that is v equal to the constant we have taken a1 into e power t. Into e power t, that is e power x into root of yz. We are taking at a small distance of x, at a small distance of x, particular point to up to the receiving end point, plus a2 into e power minus t, that is minus x into square root of yz, minus x into square root of yz. Now, again, the differentiating the equation 4, differentiating equation 4. What is the equation 4? V equal to a1 into e power x square root of yz plus a2 into e power minus x into square root of yz, differentiating with respect to the x. Now what happened? That is dv by dx equal to, this is square root of yz, e power x in the sense, that is 1 into again e power x. Again, this is differentiating d by dx of e power x, that is a into e power a, that is square root of yz into a1 into e power x square root of yz. Again, minus 1 root yz into a to e power minus x into root yz. In the both the term, root yz is common. You should take square root of yz. That is, we are getting a1 into e power x root yz. Here, this term we are getting minus 1. That is, minus of a2 into e power x into square root of yz. Now, that is, in this, the equation number 1. Already, we know that is the equation 1. That is dv by dx equal to iz. Here, what is the I? Already we have discussed. 1 by z into dv by dx. That is I equal to 1 by z into dv by dx. Now, we know the value of dv by dx. Substitute here. That is I equal to 1 by z into square root of yz a1 into e power x square root of yz minus a2 into e power minus x into root yz. Now, the simplify this equation, this we are getting I equal to, it is in the form of root yz. That is, the numerator is represented in terms of square root of yz into 1 by z. That is represent for the z. This we can write down for square root of yz. The z in the sense we can write down root z into root z. That is square root of z into square root of z. The term is not changed. That is z into z, that is square root of z square, numerator and denominator gets cancelled. That is root y into root z, square root of a into b, that is square root of a into square root of b by root z into root z. the numerator and denominator z gets cancelled. The finally we are getting square root of y by z. That is square root of y by z into a1 e power x root y z minus a2 into e power minus x into root y z. And at receiving end set, generally here you can see here this is in this diagram. At the starting point here, this is nothing but the starting point. Up to now, the distance of the receiving end we have taken for the x kilometer. Now here, that is nothing but the starting. For example, you can take the total 250 kilometer. The x equal to 250 kilometer. Now suppose in this the particular point means how much it is reaching? Reaching for example either 60 kilometer or 70 kilometer. Now in this the particular point how much it is reached? Almost 170 or 180 kilometer. Here reached for the 220 or 230 kilometer. Finally it reached means at the receiving end reached means that is nothing but again there is no further, that is 0 kilometer. At the receiving end side, that is x equal to 0 kilometer. Once it is reached, we have destination from here to any one of the place. The total 10 kilometer. We are reached means 2 kilometer. What about the remaining balance? 8. Again we are reached for the next 4 kilometer. Already 2 plus 4, 6 kilometer. What about the balance? 4. We are reached the destination. How many kilometers is left over? That is 0 kilometer. Similarly here also, at the receiving end, once it is reached to the end of the line. That is total the distance x equal to 0. What about the voltage receiving end? V equal to VR and the current I equal to IR. This the substitute equation number 4 and then equation number 5. Equation number 4 and then equation number 5. Now you can see here in this the equation number 4. The substitute x equal to 0, V equal to VR and I equal to IR. E power 0 in the sense the term is 1. E power 0 means the term is 1. If you are substituting in equation 4 this term, we are getting VR equal to, that is V is nothing but the VR equal to A1 into E power 0, that is 1, plus A2 into E power 0, that is nothing but A2 into 1. VR equal to A1 into E2. What about the equation 5 substitute here? That is I equal to square root of Y by Z. Square root of y by z into a1 into e power 0, that is x equal to 0, that is e power 0 means 1, a1 minus a2 into e power 0, that is we are getting minus a2, that is I in the sense ir, that is I equal to ir. Here in this the equation 4, equation 5 we are getting vr equal to a1 plus a2 and ir equal to square root of y by z, a1 minus a2. This is the equation. That is substitute means we are getting VR equal to A1 plus A2 and IR equal to square root of Y by Z, A1 minus A2. Now the solving these two equations, we want to know the A1 and then A2. At that time only we can know the value of VR and then IR. The simplifying these two equations, in this the equation 3, but equation 7, we are getting square root of Y by Z. What about the equation 6? The term is not. Multiply both left hand side and then right hand side, square root of y by z. But left hand side and right hand side cancel means the term is not changed. That is same value. Vr equal to a1 plus a2. Now multiply both the side, that is root y by z and then root y by z into vr and vr. Now what happened? That is vr into square root of y by z equal to a1 into square root of y by z plus a2 into square root of y by z. This is equation 6. What about the equation 7? IR equal to A1 square root of Y by Z minus A2 into square root of Y by Z. For simplifying, this is the plus and minus gets cancelled. That is A2 square root of Y by Z is cancelled. Now what happened? VR square root of Y by Z plus IR plus it should be adding 2 times of A1 into square root of Y by Z. Here we want to know the value of A1. That is A1 equal to by cross multiplication. VR square root of Y by Z plus IR by 2 times of square root of Y by Z. Now the simplifying, you can take common 1 by 2. That is VR square root of Y by Z by square root of Y by Z. Numerator and denominator gets cancelled. That is VR plus IR into, it goes to the numerator, that is square root of Z by Y. We have find out for the A value. Now we can find out the A2. Now what about the A2 in this equation 6? that is a2 equal to vr minus a1 vr minus a1. The substitute a1 value here, we are getting the a2, that is a2 equal to vr minus a1, that is a1 is 1/2 vr, again the minus 1/2 into ir square root of z/2. Here 1 minus 1/2, that is half, that is half vr minus this term, minus half into ir into square root of z/2. In this two term, 1/2 is common, that is vr minus ir into square root of z/2. Now the substitute this a1 a2 value in equation number 6 and then equation number 7, what we are getting, that is vr equal to a1 equal to, what is the simplification, vr plus ir square root of z/y/2, that is vr plus ir into zc is represent for the surge impedance, zc is represent for the surge impedance, that is surge impedance is defined as the ratio of square root of impedance to the admittance, that is z by y. The surge impedance is defined as the ratio of impedance with respect to the admittance, that is impedance, that is z equal to r plus jxl, that is connected in the series element, resistance and then inductive reactance. Admittance in the sense y equal to g plus jb, that is nothing but b is represent for the capacitive susceptance. Now what happened, the xl in the sense, xl means 2πfl, that is 2πfl, 2πf is represent for the omega, 2πf is represent for the omega, that is omega l. Now that is in the transmission line, three parameters are there, one is for the resistance, inductance, another one is for the capacitance. The due to the resistance, the losses is very less, it should be eliminated. This is represent for the j omega l, and g plus the capacitance is represent for j omega c, and the substitute value, that is the square root of j omega l by g plus j omega c. Under lossless transmission line, the leakage conductance, it should be eliminated, that is zero. G equal to zero means the finally we are getting j omega l by j omega c, that is j omega gets cancelled, that is the surge impedance, the another name is nothing but the characteristics impedance, we're getting square root of l by c. Actually in that the transmission line, the due to the surge impedance, the inductance value is the less and the capacitance value is more. Generally in the over a transmission line, the surge impedance value is represented in between, that is 400 to 600 ohm. For underground cable, the surge impedance value is 40 to 60 ohm. For over a transmission line, the surge impedance value is 400 to 600 ohm. For underground cable, the surge impedance value is 40 to 60 ohm. That is, this square root of z/y is represent for the zc, that is vr plus ir z/2. Similarly, what is the a2 value? 1/2 into vr minus ir into square root of z/y, that is represent for vr minus ir into z/2, that is zc in the sense, that is nothing but characteristics impedance or surge impedance, defined as the ratio of impedance with respect to the admittance, square root of impedance with respect to the admittance. And gamma is nothing but the propagation constant, that is alpha plus j beta, attenuation constant alpha, that is square root of y/z. And the substitute this a1 a2 value in equation number 6 and then 7, and substitute this a1 a2 value in equation 4 and then equation 5. What is the equation 4? That is v1 equal to a1 into e power x square root of yz. What is the square root of yz? Gamma. Now the substitute value, that is root of yz means gamma. Once we are substituting, that is we are getting equation number 4, v equal to vr plus ir zc by 2. This is nothing but the a1 value, e power root yz, that is e power x root yz, x gamma plus a2 value, vr minus ir zc by 2, e power minus x gamma. Similarly for equation number 5, that is I equal to square root of yz. Here we are numerator and denominator multiplying root of z by y. This the both is gets cancelled, means the value is not changed. That is a1 and then a2 value. Now here we are simplifying, that is square root of y by z into square root of z by y by root of z by y, means that is represent for the characteristics impedance or the surge impedance, the a1 minus a2. The finally we are getting I equal to vr by zc plus ir by 2 e power x gamma minus vr by zc minus ir by 2 into e power minus x gamma. That is we are simplifying, that is a1 a2 we can substitute in this, the equation number 4 and equation number 5. We are getting v value, that is equation 8. Another one is for the I value, equation number 9. That is next from the hyperbolic of the equation number 8 and then 9, that is the simplification, that is vr by 2 into e power x gamma plus ir zc by 2 into e power x gamma plus vr by 2 into e power minus x gamma minus ir zc by 2 into e power minus x gamma. This is hyperbolic equation, means the simplifying that equation number 8. Now this we can take common in this two term, vr by 2 here, vr by 2, and then here also vr by 2 is there. Finally we are getting e power x gamma plus e power minus x gamma by 2, and in this two term ir zc and ir zc you should take common, that is e power x gamma minus e power minus x gamma by 2. That is e power theta plus e power minus theta by 2, means that is represent for cos h theta. E power theta minus e power minus theta by 2, that is represent for sin h theta. Theta in the sense that is x gamma. The substitute here, v equal to pr into cos h, what is theta, gamma x, plus ir zc into sin h gamma. This is not on the voltage equation. Similarly the equation 9, the current equation you can split here, that is we are getting in this two term you should take common ir e power x gamma minus plus e power minus x gamma by 2, and what about the vr by zc, e power x gamma minus e power minus x gamma by 2. That is again ir into cos h gamma x plus vr by zc into sin h gamma x. Now this is the voltage equation and it is for the current equation. Now that is for x, means we don't know how many kilometers, just we are taken at a distance of the small change of distance x, and the length we are taken for the x. Now we can take x equal to l kilometer. Now the substitute in this, the equation number 10 and then equation 11, what happened, vs, that is v is nothing but the vs, I is is, and instead of the x, that is substitute for the x, vs equal to vr into cos h gamma l plus ir zc into sin h gamma l, and is equal to ir into cos h gamma l plus vr by zc into sin h gamma l. Now consider abcd constant parameter, that is vs equal to avr plus b into ir, and is equal to cvr plus d into ir. Compare the equation 12, 13 with respect to the 14, 15. Note on the a value, b, c, and then d. What is the value of a? Avr, a is nothing but cos h gamma l, b is zc into sin h gamma l, and the cvr, the c is nothing but 1 by zc into sin h gamma l, d is cos h gamma l. Now then this is ad minus bc, that is the substitute the value, we are getting cos h gamma l minus sin square h gamma l. That is cos square h theta minus sin square h theta, the term is for 1. Already we know that cos square theta minus sin square theta, or cos square h theta minus sin square h theta is 1. That is ad minus bc equal to 1. So we have to write for the constant ABCD parameter in the long transmission line.